topics, they give more importance. So in Infosys Quants section, few topics plays a very important role. So that I'll be telling you. One is permutation and combination, time, speed, distance, profit and loss, mensuration, and a kind of group analytical question. So you'll have only 10 questions. So Infosys is the very toughest part in IT recruitment test. So they give more importance to who has more problem solving ability and logical thinking. So today we will be discussing four important topics. One, permutation and combination. The other one, time, speed, distance. Then profit and loss and percentage. So these topics we will focus on today's webinar. Let's proceed. Problem number one, how many even numbers of three digits can be formed with the digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6? So as you all know, what is permutation and what is combination? We have discussed in the previous webinars. Permutation is number arrangement or a word arrangement. When you arrange something, it is a permutation. And first of all, you have to identify which one is permutation and combination. So most of the times you will have permutation and combination kind of problems. You'll have mixed problems. So first, let us try to identify the problem, whether it's a permutation or a combination. So read the problem. How many even numbers of three digits can be formed with the digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6? So when you read the problem, you can easily say it is a permutation problem because you are arranging the numbers, correct? So it is a permutation problem. The second, come back to the formula for permutation. You know, it is n factorial by n minus r factorial. So how do we represent permutation? npr. So n is the number of objects, r is number of arrangement. So here it is, you have to arrange even numbers of three digits. A three digit number, take an example 1, 2, and 3. So it is called unit place, 10th place, and 100th place. So it is the three digit number you have to frame, an even number. So when can you say whether a number is an even number? If it ends with, the unit digit should be 2, 4, 6, or 0. If it ends with 0, 2, 4, or 6, it is an even number. So you have to arrange a three digit even number. So since you, in the given digit, you can see like it is given 0. So this can be solved in two different cases. Case 1, when 0 occurs in unit place. So why we are taking two different cases, like in the given digits you have 0. So you have to take two different cases. Case 1, when 0 occurs in the unit place, it can be arranged only one place, the unit place. And 10th place can be arranged in 5 different ways, and 100 digit can be arranged in 6 different ways. So 6 into 5 into 1, so 30 different numbers can be framed if 0 occurs in this unit place. Case 2, when 0 doesn't occur, when 0 doesn't occur in unit place. So you have 3 places, unit place and 10 place and 100 place, and unit place, it can be filled with 2, 4 or 6. So this can be arranged in 3 different ways. So once you fill, after filling the unit place, you have to fill the 100 place. So 100 place can be filled in 5 different ways because 0 cannot occur in the 100 place. If it occurs in the 100 place, it cannot be the three digit number. So we have filled the unit place and we have filled the 100 place. So now you have to fill the 10th place with the remaining 5 digit including 0. So 5 into 5 into 3 75. So now we have to add 30 and 75. 30 plus 75, you have 105 words can be, so 105 three digit even numbers can be framed using these digits. Let's move on to the second problem. How many words can be formed out of the words banana so that the consonants occupy in the even places? So again, it is the number formation permutation problem. In permutation, you have a number formation or a word formation. For word formation, the basic formula is n factorial by p1 factorial into p2 factorial, etc. N is the number of letters, p1 is the number of times the letters repeated. Take an example, see god. Using these letters, how many words can be arranged? 3 factorial, because the number of repeated letters is not there. And taken one more example, c o o k. Using these letters, how many words can be arranged? 4 factorial by 2 factorial, because o repeated twice. So the number of repeated letters will be written as p1 factorial and p2 factorial. So this is the basic formula for the word formation. Now in this formula, in this question, like banana, how many consonants are there? B, N, N. So these are the consonants, and the vowels are triple E. So how many letters are there? 6 letters. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 places. In even places, you have to arrange consonants. So how you can arrange B, N, N, and how you can arrange? Using the formula N factorial, that is 3 factorial by N is repeated twice, so you have to write 2 factorial into the triple A, 3 factorial by 3 factorial. This is consonants and this is vowels. So 3 factorial by 2 factorial, you can write as 3 into 1. So totally 3 words you can arrange. So I'll repeat once again. There are 6 places and 6 letters you have to arrange in consonants. Can be placed in even places, and vowels can be placed in odd places. So there are 3 words only you can frame. Move to the third problem. There are 8 digit and 5 alphabets. In how many ways can you form an alphanumeric word using 3 digits and 2 alphabets? The first one you have to understand, it is a permutation or a combination. So first, so it is an word alphanumeric word formation, means it definitely a permutation. But in permutation, out of 8 digits you have to arrange a 3 digit, and out of 5 alphabets you have to pick 2 alphabets. So definitely it is a combination. The first task is, it is out of 8 digit you have to pick 3 digits, so it is a combination involved. And out of 5 alphabets you have to pick 2 alphabets. So this is the very first process. The next process, it is a word formation. These 3 plus 2 word can be arranged in 5 factorial ways. So it is a combination of both permutation and combination. 8c3, you can write it as 8 into 7 into 6 by 3 into 2 into 1. So this 8 sevens are 56, and 5c2 you can write it as 5 into 4 by 2 into 1, 10, and 5 factorial is 120. So these 5 letters can be arranged in 5 factorial ways. So totally if you multiply 560 into 120, so you can write it as 67,200. So it is a combination of both permutation and combination. Come back to the fourth problem. A team of 8 students goes on an excursion in 2 cars. So which one can see 5 and other only 4? So in how many ways can they travel? So the problem again is the combination kind of problem. You have 8 members going on excursion in 2 cars. The seating capacity of 2 cars have been given. The first one, 5. So case 1, in first car 5 can be seated, in second car 3 can be seated, in case 2 4 and 4. First car, 4 can be seated. In second car, again, 4 can be seated. So it is a combination problem. So this can be 8C5 and the remaining is 3C3. And this can be 8C4 into 4C4. So the final answer should be 8C5 plus 8C4. Adding these, you will get the answer 8C5. 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 by 5 into 4 into 3, 2 and 1. So it is 56 and 8C4, 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So it is 10 and 70. So the total number of ways is 126. So in 126 ways they can travel. The first case 5 plus 3, 5 in the first car and 2, 3 in the second car. And in second case 4 equally they can travel. So in 126 ways they can travel. Move on to the problem number 5. In an examination, a minimum marks is to be scored in each 6 subjects to pass. In how many ways a student can fail? So this is a combination problem. Like take an example, in a subject you have pass or fail. So in two different ways you can get a pass mark or a fail mark. Take an example for the two subject, okay, subject 1 and subject 2. Okay, so you can pass and fail, fail and pass, 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 fail, fail. So these are the possibilities like a student can get. So in how many ways a student can fail? So this can be fail, fail and fail. So except this all passed, only one way a student can pass. The remaining ways a student can fail. So in combination you can write as subject 1. In there are two different ways, and subject 2 again two different ways. So there are 4 ways. So that is given here, and except one way, the remaining ways a student can fail. In the same way, you can take for a 6 subject, subject 1, subject 2, subject 3, subject 4, 5 and 6. In subject 1, in 2 ways, a student can get pass or fail, again 2, and 2, 2 and 2. So 2 to the power 6. So it is 64 different combinations are available. Except one way a student can fail in 63 different ways. So problem number 6, it is a time speed distance problem. I told you like a permutation combination and time speed distance are two important topics. So this is an easy problem, like a repeated kind of problem. A man covers a certain distance between his house and office on a scooter. Having an average speed of 30 km per hour, he is late by 10 minutes. However, with a speed of 40 km per hour, he reaches his office 5 minutes earlier. So find the distance between his house and office. So the formula, as we all know, speed equal to distance by time. So what are the given data? First, we have to identify, like speed is given, it is 30 km per hour or 40 km per hour. So here two distance is given, two different parameters we have to find, and the distance is, you can take it as x, and here also x, the same distance which we need to find between the house and office. The third important thing, time. So time is not given here, but the difference of time is given here, because when you move in 30 kilometers per hour, he is late by 10 minutes. And if it moves in 40 kilometers per hour, 5 minutes earlier. So these are the informations given. As per the information data is given, we need to formulate the remaining things. So for this, take an example. You are supposed to reach the office by 9 o'clock. If you travel in 30 kilometers per hour, you are late by 10 minutes. So you will reach by 9:10. and if you move in 40 kilometer per hour, you have to reach by 9 a.m. but you will reach 5 minutes earlier, that is 8:55. Correct. So the difference between these two traveling hours is 15 minutes. So 8:55 and 9:10, it is 15 minutes. So this is the only information we have. So the first one, x by 30 time minus x by 40 equal to 15 minutes. This is the information we have. This speed by distance by speed. This is the time only we have, and the difference of time is 15 minutes. We have to convert it into hours of 15 by 60. So you multiply this by 4 and this by 3. So 4x minus 3x by 120 equal to 15 by 60, and this will be cancelled. X is equal to 30 kilometer. So this is the final answer. So this is the conventional method. You can get the answer. Move on to the problem number 7. Running 1/3 of his usual speed, a person improves his timing by 10 minutes. Find his usual time to cover the distance. So the ratio is given here. The ratio is 4:3. So this is the usual time and this is the unusual time. So they increase the speed. So in ratio, you know that 4x and 3x. So you can take it as 4 and 3 or 40 and 30. So whatever it is. So if for example, take, if they move in 30 kilometers per hour, they usually reach in the normal time. If they travel in 40 kilometers per hour, they reach 10 minutes earlier. So that is 10 minutes before, t minus 10. So these are the information we have. And again, we know that distance are same here. So distance equal to speed into time. For both, the distance are same. So you can equate S1, T1 equal to S2 and T2. The first one, if they move in 3 kilometers per hour, they reach in T time. If they move in 4 kilometers per hour, they reach 10 minutes earlier. So 3T equal to 4T minus 40, or T is equal to 10. So 10 minutes. So this is the, they're asking the usual time. If they ask you speed, you can substitute the same 30 kilometer. Problem number 8. So this is a very important problem with stoppages and without stoppages problem in time speed distances. First, let us understand the problem by reading. Without stoppages, a person travels a certain distance at an average speed of 80 kilometers per hour, and without stoppages, he covers the same distance at an average speed of 60 kilometers per hour. How many minutes per hour does he stop? So we don't know the distance. So by taking the LCM of 80 and 60, we'll come to the conclusion like the total distance. You can take it as 240. So if 240 is the distance, the first one, they can travel in 3 hours. The second one, 240 by 60, in 4 hours, they can travel. So the distance between these two is 1 hour, correct? So 1/4 for every 15 minutes once they stop. For every 1 hour, the total stopping is 60 minutes, that is a 1 hour. So the total traveling time is 4 hours. For every 15 minutes once they stop, so problem number 9, a train passes a stationary by a man on a platform in 7 seconds and passes a platform completely in 28 seconds. If the length of the platform is 330 meters, what is the length of the train? First, let us take the platform x by 7, the speed of the platform. And the speed of the platform is x plus 330 by 28. So both are equal. You can equate both. So 4x equal to x plus 330. So 3x equal to 330. X is equal to 110. So this is the answer. Problem number 10. A positive number is divided by 5 instead of being multiplied by 5. By what percentage more or less the correct answer is the resultant obtained? So take the number as 1. So they have to multiply the number by 5. So original number should be 5. So this is the original number. And see, now the number, existing number is 1 by 5. So they have divided the number by 5. So the difference between these two is 5 minus 1 by 5 is 25 minus 1 by 5 or 24 by 5. So now in 1 by 5, 24 by 5 is what percentage we have to calculate? 5 would be cancelled and 2400% is more. So this is the answer. The only thing you have to understand the problem and get the answer. The original number is 5. But the number is divided by 5. So the difference between these two is 24 by 5. So in 1 by 5, 24 by 5 is what percentage we have to calculate? It is 2400%. Next, come back to the profit and loss problem. The cost price of 10 articles is equal to the selling price of 9 articles. So find the profit percentage. So you can solve it in conventional method. But the thing is, like, again, you can take the LCM of 10 and 9. So this is equal to 90. So let us calculate the cost price of 10 articles. 90 by 10 is equal to 9. And selling price of 9 articles is equal to 90 by 9. So it is 10. So when you buy the goods for 9 rupees and sell for 10 rupees, the profit is selling price minus cost price, that is equal to 10 minus 9, 1. So profit percentage is selling price, cost price, and the profit is 1 to convert. We are multiplying by 100, so 100 by 9. So 11 into 1 by 9 percentage. So this is an easy way taking the LCM. So you'll get the total number of items sold, that is 90 by 10. First calculate cost price and selling price, then calculate the profit percentage. So move on to the problem number 12. A can of juice was 80% full and 80% of the content were emptied into the glass and 84 ml was added to the can. So initially it is 80% full. So take a can, it is 80% full, that is there are 5 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So up to 4 is filled. So 4 by 5 is full. And from the 4 by 5 and 4 by 5 is emptied and 1 by 5 is remaining. So it is 4 by 25. So it is the remaining part. And 4 by 5, 25, and with this added 84 ml and the can becomes full. So the can is taken as X and 4 by 25 is the remaining. So it is a 4x by 25 plus 84 equal to x, and 84 is equal to x minus 4x by 25. So it is 21x by 25 is equal to 24. Equal to 84. So this can be 4. So X is equal to 100. So the capacity of the tank is 100. So this is the normal method. I'll explain one more time. See, take the things like 100 ml. Assume. So 80 is full and 20 is empty. So out of 80, the 80% is 64. It is empty. The remaining 16 is there. Out of 16, when you add 84, it becomes 100 ml. Problem number 13. A grandpa is writing a book. Every morning he writes starts writing vigorously and fills a lot of pages. Post lunch, he goes through all that he has written that far and deletes 1/5 of it. He doesn't write anything more that day. At the end of the day, the previous content is still 20% more than at the end of the previous day. So how much percentage content does grandpa write in the morning? So take an example, like in the previous day, the content were 100 and at the end of the day, the content is 24. In the second day, like the content is 20% than the previous day. That is the previous day. After deleting 1/5 of the content, the content is still 20% more. So it should be 120%. The 4/5 of the content should be 120%. So the total content should be 150. So 4 parts is 120, 5 parts is 150. So the previous day it was 100. Now it is 50% more than the previous day. So the how much percentage new content does grandpa write in the morning? It is 50%. Problem number 14. In a class, 40% of the students are girls. And if 50% of the boys and 60% of the girls pass in the exam, final exam, what is the passing percentage of the girls? So if there are 100 students and 40 are girls and 60 are boys, out of 60 boys, 30 boys are passing the final exam and 60% is 24. Adding these two, we'll get the answer 54%. I'll repeat once again, there are 100 students, 40 boys, 60 boys and 40 girls. So out of 60 boys, 50% is 30 and 60% of girls is 24. So the final is 54%. So try to understand the problem and get the answer. So the next part we'll be discussing the crypto arithmetic and the group kind of problems. So thank you very much for watching. So if you have any doubts, you can always mail us to friends@placementseason.com or you can WhatsApp your doubts. Thank you very much for watching. See you again.